हरे कृष्णा, इफ यू कांट ऑफर विद अ प्योर हार्ट देन ऑफर टू गेट अ प्योर हार्ट। द प्रोसेस ऑफ डिवोशन इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ डेवलपिंग अ रिलेशनशिप विद कृष्णा एंड दिस रिलेशनशिप बोथ रिक्वायर्स प्यूरिटी एंड इट डेवलप्स प्यूरिटी। टू बी एबल टू रिलेट विद कृष्णा and to relish the sweetness of devotion to him, we need to have a pure heart. But even if we don't have a pure heart, still, if we just keep practicing bhakti, if we just keep trying to connect with him, because he's all pure, pavitranam pavitram yo mangalanam cha mangalam, because he's supremely pure, because he's supremely auspicious, by connecting with him, we become purified gradually. And in that way, we develop purity. So this dynamic of the two-way relationship, we either offer with a pure heart or we offer to get a pure heart. This is illustrated in the Bhagavad Gita 9.26 and 27. In 9.26, Krishna states that patram pushpam phalam toyam yome bhaktya prayachati tadaham bhakti upahritam ashnami prayatatmanaha. He says, patram pushpam phalam toyam, that you can offer me a fruit, a flower, a leaf, or even water. And tadaham bhakti uparitam, if it is offered with devotion, ashnami prayatatmanaha, I will accept it, Krishna says. So here the word prayatatmanaha, the soul who is purified, that is talked about. So Krishna doesn't want anything materially opulent. If you just offer him with sincere devotion, he is satisfied, even if the offering is very simple. But then, while at one level, this verse can give us hope that even if we do not have a lot of material resources to offer to Krishna, if we just have a devotional intent, Krishna will be pleased with that. But at the same time, it may also create a sense of insecurity and fear, because what if we don't have devotion? Then can we not offer anything to Krishna? And how will we ever connect with him? That concern Krishna addresses in the next verse. When he states, yat karoshi dashnasi yat juhosi dadasi yat yat tapasyasi kaunteya tat kurushva madarpanam. So he says that whatever you do, yat karoshi dashnasi, whatever you do, whatever you eat, whatever you give away, whatever you sacrifice, tat kurushva madarpanam, you offer that to me. So here, Krishna is recognizing the possibility that people may not have a pure heart and they may do things because they like to do those things, because they want to do those things. But Krishna says, anyway, even if your primary driving intention is that you like to do that, still you offer that to me. Karushvamadarpanam, offer that to me. Why? Because at least by that offering, one will become purified, one will become elevated. Because that is that connection with Krishna. And that, so here Krishna accommodates that even if devotion, even if we don't have pure devotion, even if our devotion is weak and is something like an afterthought, still we can offer to him. And he assures that even by such offering, gradually you will become purified. That he assures in the next verse when he says 9.28, Shubha Shubha Falairevam Mokshase Karma Bandhanai Sanyasa Yoga Yuktatma Vimukto Mam Upaishyasi. So he says, Shubha Shubha Falairevam, in this way, being freed from the auspicious and inauspicious results of work, Mokshase Karma Bandhanai, one becomes freed from bondage, Sanyasa Yoga Yuktatma Vimukto. To mam upaishyasi, one becomes liberated and attains Krishna. Vimukto, special liberation in which one attains Krishna. Mam upaishyasi. So, even if we have a pure heart, wonderful. Whatever we offer, Krishna will accept. But even if we don't have a pure heart, we don't have to lose hope. Still, we can offer to Krishna at whatever level we can. Whenever we remember Krishna, we can offer whatever we're doing to him. And by that connectedness with him, gradually we will become elevated, we will become purified, and eventually we will attain him. Such is the accommodating and merciful nature of Krishna. Thank you. हरे कृष्ण।